Hello everyone, good morning. In today's video we will see how to execute your fourth C program. So we will discuss this fourth C program here. See here. See here, program number 4. This is your fourth C program. So write a C program to calculate and display student result using nested if. In previous video we discussed even an odd number program. In that program I have used the if conditions. There are number of conditions: if condition, nested if condition, if else ladder. These all conditions we will use. So in today's program we will use the nested if. What is the difference between if condition and nested if? In if condition we will in previous video we discussed the if else condition, nested if condition. So what is the difference between if else condition and nested if? See here, in if else condition we use only one if condition, but in nested if we will use more than two if conditions. Mean number of if conditions we will use in this program, so that so the name of this condition is nested if. So using that nested if we will execute this fourth C program. This is a student result sheet. Means how we can calculate the total and average of a particular student. So that we will discuss here. See, first write down the header files hash include stdio.h and hash include ponio.h. Write down these two header files, then void main function, then start of C program, execution of start of C program, start from here, then int. I'll declare here data type as a int because we are using the total. This total is a variable and int is a data type. So this data type hold a variable. See here, in this video we are assigning the variable value here. This is total is a variable, so assigning first total value is 0. Total value is 0. After entering the marks, means adding the each subject marks, we will get the exact total of a particular student. So first initially you assign the value of total is 0. This is called as assigning the value to the variable. In theory part we discussed about how to assign the values to the variable. You see that video, you will get the idea. Variable means what? How we can assign the values to the variable. See here, this is a int is here, data type, then total value is equals to 0. Then int means we are using the integer values here, means only integer numbers. Don't use here fraction values because you have used here int. So use integer value only. So m1 means marks 1, first subject marks, then second subject marks m2, third subject marks, fourth subject marks, fifth subject marks and sixth subject marks, because we have total 6 subjects. So enter the 6 subject marks. This is m1 first subject marks, second subject, like this. Enter m6, then float average. Why I have used here float for average? Because always average is a fraction values. Because see here, if you calculated your percentage, so percentage always in fraction values, means 90.85%, 50.60%, means these are the fraction values. So use here float, because average or percentage comes in fraction values. So use float average. Then write down the CLR, SCR function here. Clear screen function to clear the previous output screen. Then printf means whatever message you want to print on monitor screen. So write it here. Slash n. Why I have written here slash n? If you are not written slash n, your enter 6 subject marks comes here. If you want to enter subject marks comes to the new line, use here slash n. Enter 6 subject marks colon. This message will display. Then you can enter here 6 subject marks. Scanf %d 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 %D. Why I have written this %D 6 times? Because we are using here 6 subject. So for each subject 1% D. For M2 2% D, like this 6% D. Ample sign M1, M2, M3, like this M6, means enter the 6 subject marks here, and this will fetch the address of the address of the value, means in which place that number is saved. When calculating that time, it will fetch that, means fetch the address of that number. Then total, write down the formula of the total. Total means what? Addition of 6 marks. So total equals to M1 plus, means subject 1, plus marks of subject 2, plus like this 6 subject addition. This is a total. You will get here total value. Then average. What is the formula of average? How you can find out average? Average equals to total, whatever value we will get here, that value divided by 6. Why I have written here 6? Because we are using here 6 subjects, so divided by 6. If you are using 4 subjects, so divided by 4. If there are 8 subjects, divided by 8, like this. Okay, average equals to total by 6. Using this formula, we will calculate the average or percentage. Then print f slash n. Total equals to %D. I have written here printf because this using this formula computer will calculate the values. If you want to calculated value see on the monitor screen, so for displaying purpose, write down printf slash n total equals to %D, means whatever result we will get here, that result it will display on monitor screen. Total equals to %D. Then slash n. Why I have written here slash n? See, if you removed this slash n, so total total value this, and suddenly there is no here no space comes, suddenly the average comes. It mix up in one line only. If you want average is below the total, so use here slash n, means from average it comes to the new line. Average equals to percent f. Why I have written here percent f? Because for total I have used here int, and for average I have used here float. So use here percent f total comma average. See, here we are using the more than two if conditions, that is known as the nested if conditions. Okay, if M1 is, means marks of first subject is less than 35, this symbol is known as the pipeline. We are using two pipelines. This symbol indicates the or, this or this, this or this, this or this, like this. Second subject marks is less than 35. Third subject, if anyone, means there are six subject, in six subject if anyone subject marks is less than 35, then your result will print fail. See here, in exam if you got less than 35 marks in any one subject, your result comes fail. Okay, if this condition is true, this result will print on the monitor screen. If this condition is false, this printf statement is skipped. It comes to the else part, and else part will execute. Means it comes in else part. It will check now if condition. If average is greater than or equals to 35, means whatever percentage or whatever average you have calculated, that average is greater than or equals to 35, and average is less than 50, means your average is between 35 and 50. In between if you got average, your result is pass class, means you got the pass class. And then if this condition is true, this result will print. If this condition is false, it comes to the else part. Computer will check this condition now. If average is greater than or equals to 50 and average is less than 60, means your average is in between 50 and 60, you will get the second class. It will print the second class result. If this condition is true, this result will print. If this condition is false, it comes to the else part. Computer will check this condition. If average is greater than or equals to 60 and average is less than 75, means your average is between 60 and 75, you will get the first class. that result will print. If this condition is false, it comes to the else part. The computer will check now this condition. Your average is greater than or equals to 75. Means equals to 75 or more than 75, then your result is distinction. It will print on the monitor screen distinction. Then close gate CH and close your program. See, this is the output of your program. If you have if you type that program, if you run your program, this output screen, this output screen will display on monitor screen. First, it will display enter six subject marks. Then colon. Then you can enter the six subject marks from keyboard. I have entered here 90, 80, 70, 60, 98, and 88. Six subject marks. This 3, 3, 6. Then you will, if you press enter here, you will get this result. Total equals to the addition of these six numbers is 486. And average of 486 is 81.00. Why it shows 00? Because I have declared average as a fraction value, means floating value. So it shows the decimal point, means fraction values. 81.00% you got. Then result is distinction. Why it's distinction? Because it's more than 75. It's greater than 75. So result is distinction. Like this, your output will print on monitor screen. So we will see how to execute that program. Okay, just click on open the Turbo C++ software. Just click here. See here, in previous video, in program number 3, this type of screen comes. If you want this window in bigger size, means maximize, if you want to maximize this window, there is a shortcut key for this. So here, go to file and take a new file. But this window is a smaller window. If you want this window is bigger, there is a shortcut key for this. From your keyboard, place Alt, hold the Alt key and just press the Enter key. Your window will bigger in size, means it is maximized. Okay, then type your program here. See here, already I typed the fourth program, because that program is a bigger, so it will get a more time. So I'll show you how to execute. See here, if you already saved your program, if you want to open like this, you can open. Go to file, just click on open. Here you can type your whatever name you have given for your program. I have given the P4, means fourth program. Then click on open. See, this is a fourth program is open here. Then compile, Alt C key, enter. See, there is no warnings and there is no error. So press any key from keyboard, just press. Then Alt R, just press the enter key, run the program. See, enter the six subject marks. Enter six subject marks from keyboard here. See here, I am entering marks. Just press enter key, otherwise press space key. See here, total is we got, if you add these six numbers, total is equals to 360 and average is 65.00. so result is first class, means the average is between 50 and 60. Your result comes first class. If you want to go back to your main screen, just press the enter key. See here, in this program I'll do some mistakes, means how to find out the errors. If you have done some mistakes in your program, if error comes, how to find out it? See here, I'll do some mistakes. See, I'll write here B capital C. If you have written B, any letter is capital here. I'll write here print B capital. सी फॉर इफ कंडीशन सेमी कॉमा डोंट गिव सेमी कॉमा ओके फॉर इफ कंडीशन डोंट गिव सेमी कॉमा बिकॉज इफ कंडीशन इज नॉट टर्मिनेटेड बाय सेमी कॉमा सी हियर इफ यू हैव गिवन सेमी कॉमा व्हाट टाइप ऑफ एरर इट शोज वी विल शो यू हियर वेट आई डू सम मिस्टेक्स इन प्रोग्राम देन वी विल फाइंड आउट See here, if you return here a small average, if you are not written here f function, only you have written print. If you have written this capital letter, see here I have done some mistakes in program. So now compile your program, Alt C, then compile. See here, if you are executing on computer or laptop, so for compilation, Alt C key for compile and Alt R for run. And if you are executing this program on mobile, at the bottom of your mobile, there comes compile and run. Just you click on that, okay? Compile and run. Your program will compile and run. Just press the enter key. See here, error is 1. There is one error, just press the enter key. There are number of errors, but it shows, sometimes it shows the less number of errors. And when you find out that error, then again you run your program, it shows the number of errors like this. See here, it shows the error in which line using this color. See here, in this line there is an error because I have written here V capital because always write down the void main function in lowercase letter. So I have written here V capital, so it shows error. So in this line, it shows what type of error in this line. In this line, it shows in below message box. See here, in message box using green color, it shows what type of error is there in that line. Here declaration syntax error because we have not because I have not declared the main function correctly because see here if you want to declare the function void main function it's write down in always in lowercase letter. This is the syntax. I have not declared syntax properly here, so it show the error declaration syntax error. Just press the enter key, remove that capital letter, enter small letter here, then Alt C, press Alt C. See here, now it shows the number of errors. This is errors are 5, there are no warnings. So press any key from keyboard. See here, in this line there is a error. Printf, enter the 6 subject marks. What type of error in this line? It shows in message box. See here, function printf should have a prototype. Means whatever printf function you have written, it is not correct, means should have a prototype. You have not declared this syntax is properly. Why it shows? Because printf, this is a syntax, so write down the syntax in lowercase letter. But in this line, I have used here P is capital. P is capital, this is not a format, means this is not a syntax correctly. So it shows here error, function printf should have a prototype, means you should write down the correct prototype of printf. Just press the enter key, remove the P capital and small, write down, just press the Alt C key, enter, compile the program. Now the error comes 4, so just press the enter key. See here, misplaced else. Here it will not show in which line error is there, only it shows the message here. Sometimes of there are many types of errors. This type of error it will not show in any particular line, it will display only message in message box. This is known as the misplaced else. Why it shows misplaced else? See, if you not written if condition properly, then this type of error it shows in message box. Misplaced else means you have not written if conditions properly. Just press the enter key. See here, it shows error in this else, because see here, if condition is not terminated by semicomma, so it shows misplaced else. If you have given semicomma to if else if condition, then it shows the message misplaced else. So remove this, then compile. See, the first there are 5 errors. Now I have removed 2 errors. Now it shows 3 errors. So find out that 3 errors. Just press the enter key. So in this line error is there. What type of error is there? It shows in message box. See here, undefined symbol average. Why it shows undefined symbol average? Because see here, this is average. Undefined symbol average. Here average. Because we have declared, see here, undefined means you have not defined here, means you have not defined, means you have not given variables, you have not used properly. See here, I have defined here average A is capital, but here I have written small letter. See here, I have used here, see here, I have used here small letter, so it shows you have not defined average. Okay, remove this A and put capital average, because I have declared that average is capital A. Alt C, enter. Now 2 errors, so just press the enter key. See, in this line there is an error. What type of error is there? Function print should have a prototype, means you should you have not written printf function properly. So you have written only print here, f is missing here, so this is not a proper prototype. So write down here print f. Alt C, compile. See, there is only one error. Just press the enter key. See here, it shows this type of error. It will not show using the that line. It will display it on message box. See here, function gate ch should have a prototype, means this prototype is not declared you have correctly, means you have not written there correctly this prototype. Because see here, you have used here G is capital, but the syntax, the proper syntax is write down this syntax in lowercase letter, don't use caps letter here. Just press the enter key, remove this G capital, write down small letters gate ch. Okay, Alt C, compile. See, there is no warnings and no error. So press any key from keyboard. See here, I have removed the semicomma. See, from here, Alt C, compile the program. See, there it shows two errors. See, what type of error is there? Statement missing semicomma. You have missed the semicomma. So just press the enter key. Give here semicomma, Alt C, compile. There is no warnings, there are no errors. So press any key. Now you can run your program. If there are errors, don't run your program, otherwise your screen goes, means your program will not work. First compile the program, see the errors, then find out that errors, then you run the program. If it shows warnings are 00, if there are no errors, then only you can run the program. So using Alt R key, run your program. See here, enter the 6 subject marks. So enter from keyboard 6 subject marks. See here, I am entering one subject marks is 20. What result we will get here? See, other marks are good, but in one subject he or she got less marks. See here, total of this 6 subject, if you add these 6 subjects, so you will get total equals to 465. Average is 77.00%, means average is 77%, and result is fail. Why the result is fail? Because in 5 subject he got good marks, but in first subject he or she got only 20. So it is 20 is less than 35. If any particular student got in any one subject less than 35 marks, then that result is fail. that student will fail here. So result is fail. Just press the enter key. See here, what is the use of slash n? I'll remove this slash n and show you. I'll see compile. There is no errors. Alt R, run. See here, enter the marks. See here, total is 548, means addition of that all subject marks is 548, average is 91%. See, if you removed the slash n from result, it comes in only single line. If you want to come this result to below of average, if you want to result comes in new line, so you should use slash n before the result. See here, average 91% 00, suddenly there is no space comes, suddenly result equals to distinction, means it whatever message you have written, that it will print in only single line. It's very confusing, so use slash n. So I have removed slash n from here. So you write down slash n, then now compile the program, run your program. See here, now I am entering the marks. See here, total is 347. The total of this 6 subject marks is 347. Average is 57%. He or she, I mean that student got 57% and result is second class. Why the result in second class? Because if anyone student, if he or she got marks in between the 50 and 60, means average is in 50 or 60, then result comes second class. Like this you can execute your program. If you want to quit this, just click here Alt X button from keyboard, otherwise click on quit. Yes, I want to save that program. This is your fourth program. I'll stop here. In next video we will see the next program, how to execute.